coming up on Pierce County News.
We made it happen, and it's just great for the citizens.
Sprinker's ice rink opens. 82 acres of island land is preserved. And see Pierce County's new jury room. Hi, and welcome to Pierce County News. I'm Heather Radel. The Sprinker Recreation Center's ice arena is back open after an eight-month closure to repair the roof and rehab the rest of the historic rink. PCN's Rick Van Sice has more.
The new ice rink reopened a week late, delayed ironically by the 2012 ice storm. But for these skaters, it was worth the wait. The problems that shut down this popular part of Sprinker last year were gone for good. No more rusty roof from years of condensation that rained on the rink below, making puddles and divots in the ice. Early on, the rink was threatened with closure due to these structural worries, but the Pierce County Executive and Council were able to address the most critical needs and carve the rehab price down to $6.5 million with no new taxes. It was money well spent and well supported.
I want to thank all of the active citizens in Pierce County who made it very clear to us and everybody else they spoke to that they wanted Sprinker Ice Arena and Recreation Center to be a part of Pierce County's quality of life for years to come.
The County Council was also, along with the County Executive, able to use some additional funds that became available because of some changes in state law that allowed us to do some additional upgrades to what was originally planned.
And how appropriate was this? A ceremonial ribbon cutting, not with scissors, but a Zamboni, driven by none other than Pierce County Executive Pat McCarthy. In the spirit of Sprinker's past ice shows, these young skaters put on a quick performance before the public rented their blades and took to the ice for the first time in nearly a year. Under a tightly sealed roof, bright lights, and with modern refrigeration that keeps the surface cold while the air stays warm.
We made it happen, and it's just great for the citizens. So, as I like to say, Sprinker is a part of our future, not our past.
In this case, putting Sprinker on ice didn't mean an end, but a new beginning. In Spanaway, Rick Van Sice, Pierce County News.
We love Sprinker!
You don't have to be a skater to enjoy the new rink. Come see a professional ice show in the new arena called Reflections on Ice. There are a handful of performances on February 10th, 11th, and 12th. See Olympic bronze medalist Joseph Sabovchek perform with skaters from the Lakewood Winter Club. Tickets are available at Sprinker. If you like to kayak and enjoy the wildlife our area has to offer, you'll soon have 82 acres of permanently protected land to explore on Anderson Island. Grants from Pierce County and the state of Washington helped the conservation group Forterra purchase an 82-acre peninsula known as Jacobs Point. It will be permanently protected for recreation and wildlife habitat.
We could not do it alone if we didn't have the Conservation Futures program that we have, and working with Forterra and with the state, we couldn't have made this happen.
The property is located on the south side of Anderson Island on Oro Bay and includes 1 mile of unaltered Puget Sound shoreline. The Anderson Island Park and Recreation District will manage the property and plans to develop public access for land trails and a stop for kayaks and canoes. The land will also provide habitat for endangered Chinook, chum, and pink salmon. An agreement that would give Lakewood full control of Fort Steilacoom Park by the year 2015 is headed to the Pierce County Council for approval. Under the proposed deal, Pierce County would pay the city of Lakewood $50,000 a year through 2014 when the county's lease expires. The money would help offset Lakewood's cost to manage the 340-acre park, which is more than $400,000 a year.
This is a regional park, and a lot of people are using it and consuming the resources, and so it's good that we figure out what is the right amount that we should be contributing to this park.
From 2006 to 2010, the city and county split the cost of maintaining the park. Last year, the county contributed $150,000. This three-year agreement is designed to help Lakewood transition to full ownership.
You said originally the termination with the state was to happen already, but this has now extended it to 2014. Is there any reason you see that it would not be executed at 2014.
Only if council and the county executive's office decide that they want to do something different. As far as I'm concerned, our obligation should end there.
Fort Steilacoom Park is Lakewood's biggest park and has everything from a dog park to miles of walking trails plus ball fields and a large playground. County leaders say the transfer to city ownership will help the county focus attention on other county parks. The county council is expected to vote on the proposed agreement sometime next month. For more information, go to piercecountywa.org/council. An anti-idling policy in Pierce County helped the county save more than 33,000 gallons of gas last year. It's just one of the many ways the county is working to implement environmental changes. Joining me today is Ryan Dix. He is a sustainability manager with Pierce County. Ryan, tell me about the anti-idling policy and what does 33,000 gallons of gas translate into money-wise?
Well, it's a lot of fuel, and as we all know, fuel is expensive these days. So last May in 2011, we instituted a fuel reduction policy with three main goals: making sure that our drivers of Pierce County aren't idling unnecessarily, also making sure that we have the right size vehicle for the job and the mission they have. And then the last piece, which I think is critical, is helping drivers understand how they can drive more efficiently. We call it green driver tips. Altogether, though, we saved about 32,000 gallons, 33,000 gallons, and it saved over $110,000 in cost. And we can all, in these economic times, we can all afford to save some money on gasoline.
That's amazing. Now, what about other environmental practices that the county's working on?
You know, the county is really looking at how we can reduce waste in all different forms. Certainly gasoline reduction is hugely important. Also, we're doing more recycling. We've increased our recycling by over 30% at our facilities. And we've reduced our energy use, which is also a money saver, by about 11%. And that equates to about a $350,000 savings every year. So it's really been good.
Now, I understand that Pierce County has one of the worst wood smoke problems in the country. What could people do to help reduce that problem?
Well, we do have a significant wood burning issue. People are using wood to heat their homes. The main thing I want to focus on is the burn bans. When we have a dry day where we have an inversion and the wind is not up and it's not raining, those are the days where we have problems, and the problems are specifically in the winter. So if you're wondering, is there a burn ban, am I allowed to burn or not, you should call. There's a 1-800 number where you can call and find out whether there's a burn ban. Secondly, if you are going to burn, it's really important to burn seasoned wood. And that means wood that's been out of the rain for at least a year and preferably up to 2 years. So there's a real art to burning wood well, and that would be something to focus on.
Are there any other tips for people on how to help the environment, but also maybe save some money?
Yeah, you know, we do a lot of research on ways we can save money at Pierce County. Obviously, driving less is a huge piece. Cars are expensive, gasoline's expensive. So the less you drive, the more you'll save. Programmable thermostats at your home can save you a lot of money. I know it saved me about $30 a month on my home energy bill. Also, washing your clothes on cold water. That's another tip that can save you a lot on your hot water heater bills. So those are the kinds of things that can help at home.
All right. Thanks so much, Ryan. Yeah.
Thank you.
Well, if you're a taxpayer in Pierce County, you can get a look at your 2012 tax statement starting this week. This year's taxes will be posted on the Assessor Treasurer's website at piercecountywa.org/ATR starting the evening of February 3rd. Property tax statements for 2012 collections will be delivered to Pierce County residents who pay their own taxes starting February 15th. If your taxes are paid through your mortgage company, the information will be sent to them. If you haven't received a statement by the end of the month, you can call 253-798-6111 to request it. The next time you get called for jury duty in Pierce County, there's no need to dread it. Megan Hutton shows us what makes the new jury waiting room more comfortable.
Orange badge 19, orange badge 20,
here. Jury duty. It's an important responsibility and the basic foundation of our judicial system. But there can be a lot of waiting, and until now, it was in a small room with no windows.
It just wasn't a comfortable area. It wasn't welcoming at all for the jurors, sadly. It was cramped oftentimes. So we really needed to address the growing number of jurors that we were summoning in.
The County City Building in Tacoma has a new jury room that should bring smiles to the nearly 300,000 people the county summons each year. The new room can hold 200 to 300 people. There is a wall of windows and a taller ceiling, a kitchenette, and better ventilation to keep the room cool. If being away from your job is difficult, the Wi-Fi signal makes it easy to work remotely.
That's really made a big difference to me, being jury averse or not, because I can still do my work here. Lately, I've been doing stuff with mobile platforms like iPads, iPhones, this crazy stuff, as well as my laptop. So the Wi-Fi connects me to all that. I can still do some productive work.
Yesterday, I wasn't in here very much at all. Today, I mean, it's nice having the window because I like having the natural light instead of being in a cave. So this is, it's really nice.
The county will be adding a secure outdoor patio this year, so jurors won't have to go back through security just to get some fresh air.
Sometimes, as you can tell, that there is a downtime and that the jurors that are called do not just immediately go off to a courtroom. So I think anything that we can do to make it a little bit more pleasant for them, I hope, is appreciated.
Getting in and out of the waiting room is easier with more doorways and a larger check-in area. Jurors can choose the staffed windows or use computers for self-check-in.
People are able to go to the counter and get help, or they can go to a self-check-in area, or they can just go check and sit down where they need to and be able to come in and out as they please and not get bottlenecked at the door.
Juror safety is also improved with a secure hallway for transporting inmates. The main hallway can also be closed off during transports. Megan Hutton, Pierce County News.
Coming up next, if wedding bells are in your future, see a Pierce County location that's taking brides by surprise. We're back in just 60 seconds.
Treat everything you own like it's a pile of cash. That's what thieves do. Please don't leave your valuables unattended.
Welcome back. There's a new hotspot for lovebirds looking for a great place to have their wedding. Pierce County's beautiful Chambers Creek properties above Puget Sound, where Rick Van Sice reports people do more than just play, they get hitched too.
You know the Chambers Creek properties for hiking, beachcombing, or golfing at Chambers Bay. But the place is also a launching pad for lifetime commitments. And a place to celebrate them too.
I think it's, you know, the natural beauty of the area, and you know, the view from this location is about as good as any in Tacoma, and certainly there's something, you know, about a church wedding, but I think being outdoors here with the view and the mountains and the water is, you know, it's a special option here also.
Lately, more and more couples seem to agree with that and are getting married at one of two distinct venues at the properties, the Chambers Bay Golf Course and the Environmental Services Building, or ESB. The number of people tying the knot on these bluffs above Puget Sound has grown steadily since 2002. That's because there's more than just scenery. Both facilities have full kitchen and catering facilities to make the best-looking wedding taste great, too. And each has a list of reputable vendors for ordering everything from food to flowers to decorations and music. The setting at the Chambers Creek properties couldn't be better.
One, two, three.
But what if a picture-perfect sunset isn't in the forecast?
Rain or shine, yeah, we've done a handful of ceremonies inside the pavilion there where we just kind of move the tables and make an aisle in between there, and really is surprising even to me how beautiful it can look inside there. And, you know, almost not quite as good as the view here, but certainly is, we've had nothing but great experiences when we have to move it inside.
Rain or shine, it's never too early to book your wedding at either Chambers Bay or the Environmental Services Building. Dates for next year are already filling up. I'm Rick Van Sice, Pierce County News.
Up next, get the scoop on skating and ballroom dancing lessons with Parks and Rec. But first, here are some dates for your calendar. Pierce County Community Connections is offering free workshops on reverse mortgages. The workshops focus on how seniors who are 62 and older can use their home equity to stay in their homes longer. The workshops will be held at four locations in Tacoma and University Place on February 13th and 15th. They are free, open to the public, and no RSVP is required. For more information, call 253-798-4600 or visit pierceadrc.org. Bring your friends or that special Valentine to Sumner's Sweetheart Wine Walk coming up Saturday, February 11th. More than a dozen shops in downtown Sumner will be sampling wine and offering a taste of the local flavor. Tickets are $15 for six tastes. For more information, go to sumnerdowntown.com. This week, Kyle Wintermute takes us to his favorite place with a new look. Hi, Kyle.
Hi, Heather. So you've been out to Sprinker for the grand reopening, but not sure about getting onto the ice? Well, I've got good news for you. Skating classes are starting soon. If you've got the desire, we've got the classes, no matter if you've only skated once or have enough skills to get around the rink easily. Our professional staff can teach you the skating skills to make this a lifelong pastime. Ice skating and hockey skills classes start up mid-February, and there's still plenty of room to sign up. So call or go online for more information. If you like watching Dancing with the Stars and wonder how sports stars, actors, and singers can learn to dance so elegantly, so quickly, well then come find out at Pierce County Parks and Recreation. We've got beginning ballroom classes starting in February, and it'll give you the moves and the confidence to navigate any dance floor. So put on your dancing shoes and shuffle on over for some fun this winter. We encourage people to dance like nobody's watching and play like you're five again. I'm Kyle Wintermute for Pierce County News. Back to you, Heather.
Thanks, Kyle. You can see Pierce County from here on PCTV. We have the original programming you can't find anywhere else. For more local focus on the Pierce County economy, watch a special presentation called Horizons 2012. Catch it Tuesdays at 8 p.m. or Sundays at noon. I'm Heather Radall. Thanks for watching Pierce County News.
You are watching PCTV, Channel 22. See Pierce County from here. On the next Rainier Country from PCTV, the community comes together to build a playground by the sound. Plus, an extraordinary change to a very ordinary place. See an old alley blossom into something new. And we discover a quiet trail to Puget Sound, just steps from a busy suburb.
It's a great escape. If you live, work, or play here, it's a great escape.
Watch PCTV's Rainier Country Sunday nights here on PCTV Channel 22.
Preparing today reduces the consequences of a disaster tomorrow.
In Pierce County, more than 1,600 people don't have a place to call home.
More than 400 of these are children.
On any given night, as many as 300 people go to sleep in a car,
an abandoned building,
or on the street.
So why are so many people homeless?
Medical bills, bankruptcy, divorce,
domestic violence,
job loss, housing costs,
illness,
and disability are some of the most common causes.
They're unfortunate circumstances that could happen to any of us.
Every year, more of our neighbors, our families, and our friends become homeless.
But every day,
each person who joins in the fight to end homelessness
brings us that much closer to a solution.
So why should I care?
Because we're all in this together.
Because every child should have a home.
Because it could happen to any of us.
Because I can make a difference.
Because it's the right thing to do.
Why should we end homelessness?
Because we can.
So, what's it gonna be? We could ride bikes, skating, movies, zoo, whatever you guys wanna do.
Can we just do this?
Yeah. We could just do this.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today.
So, I'm kind of new here, but I've noticed a trend. My human does this funny thing where she goes around and gets all my toys, and then she hides them in that basket by the door. You know, but it's always the same basket, and it's always in the same place. And then she acts so surprised when I find them, but, you know, she's putting them in the same basket again. It's like, hello, that's where you put it last time. You were the worst at hide-and-go-seek.